Today we are going to discuss Deakin's reaction. Deakin's reaction is the reaction of ortho or para hydroxypentaldehyde with alkaline hydrogen peroxide to obtain dihydric phenols. I mean, in this reaction, aldehyde group ultimately get replaced by hydroxyl group. Now what happens in this case? In case of ortho hydroxypentaldehyde, we all know very well that aldehyde group is polar one. So due to difference in electronegativity and being more electronegative, oxygen gives electron pair. So this carbon is susceptible for nucleophilic attack. Therefore, nucleophile from hydrogen peroxide simply attacks at this carbon, which lead to the formation of an intermediate, which can be written as, this is the new intermediate soap octet. Now at this point, hydroxide ion, I mean OH negative ion, ultimately get departure, due to which this oxygen becomes electron deficient, and at this point ultimate rearrangement takes place as well. So on gross, one can mention the newly formed intermediate as, so intermediate so obtained can be written as, this is the intermediate so obtained. Now to this intermediate, nucleophilic attack can be seen at this carbon in this manner. Now due to which another intermediate which can be mentioned as, this is the intermediate so obtained. Now at this point, departure of formic acid takes place in this manner. Have a look at this. Oxygen keeps electron, shares electron pair right here. And this oxygen being more electronegative than carbon keeps electron pair towards itself. Due to this, formic acid ultimately get departure, and that lead to the formation of the new intermediate, what we call alkoxide ion. Now this ion accepts proton from solvent, and by doing that, would that lead to the formation of desired product catechol, that is dihydric phenol. In this way, one can convert ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde to catechol. I mean, the aldehyde group can be successfully replaced by hydroxyl group using this reaction. Thank you very much.